Struck. Thanks to Huey for the request from my Patreon page, and he requested Kid Clown in Crazy Chase. And there is a lot going on in this game. Where do I even start? Okay, to set the stage, we have a kidnapped princess, we have an evil pirate named Blackjack, we have a clown king who sends Kid Clown to rescue said princess, only Kid Clown is kind of a dingus. He's not the most graceful or agile hero, as there's a lot of slapstick humor here, and I guess that's what this game was going for in terms of appeal. Because the gameplay is kind of a mess. It goes like this. Blackjack sets up a bomb and rolls a needlessly and egregiously long fuse to light it. Kid Clown has to race down in this isometric viewpoint to prevent it from going off, all while dodging rolling logs, spikes, cannonballs, and various other enemies and obstacles. It's kind of interesting because you hold down to speed up and you hold up to slow down to a stop so you can grab all sorts of items like coins and these cards or card suits, I guess, and you need to collect all four of them to complete the level. There's a couple problems with this though. Number one is that it's frustrating to get a feel for the 3D effect going on here. You have to get underneath these balloons, jump and pull on their strings in order to obtain the card things. Once you walk past these though, you cannot go back up. Holding up is designed only to slow you down to a stop, not to go back up. So it's easy to miss a lot of these balloons, and that's frustrating. The momentum behind the controls here just feels way too sensitive. It's too easy to just sprint past everything. The biggest problem with the game, however, is that everything hurts you. And not only that, but for all the damage you sustain, you have to sit through an animation sequence of Kid Clown humorously dusting himself off or shaking off the cobwebs or whatever. And yeah, to the game's strength, the sprite work here is really impressive. The developer Kemco really put a lot of work into the Kid Clown sprite. But I mean, he stepped in a puddle, a freaking puddle. Now I have to sit here while he dramatically reacts to the damage he sustained while being wet? That's pretty dang ridiculous. I mean, it just never ends. There's axes flying at you, bushes give you a wedgie, and even the stuff that's supposed to help you sometimes hurts you. Come on, man. I mean, I guess that's one reason to play the game, to look at all the crazy damage animations, because there's tons of them. But you won't get to see very many because the first stage is so freaking hard. There are 5 stages, though, in addition to 3 endings, a bad ending, a good ending, and an okay-ish ending, I guess. The thing is that you have to be absolutely perfect to get the good ending. No deaths, no continues, all the items. Good luck. No saves or passwords here, either. One redeeming value Kid Clown has are the mini-games in between stages. The number of coins you collect in the stage determines the number of attempts or time you have to play. I like this air hockey one myself. Couldn't we just have had Kid Clown in air hockey land? There's also these seemingly random bonus areas you get vaulted to every now and again. I guess certain obstacles just trigger them? The game moves by so quickly that it's tough to determine which one sent you there. But yeah, it's usually just more opportunities at coins. Kid Clown and Crazy Chase also received a Game Boy Advance port, and not only that, it got 11 new levels and a multiplayer mode, so if you really dig this game, then you'll have to check that out for sure. But yeah, Kid Clown and Crazy Chase for Super Nintendo looks good, sounds good, the music is good, but the controls are as awkward as it gets, and combined with the 3D effect here, it makes for a really frustrating playthrough. I mean, they even have an ice-themed level here, which just makes the controls even more frustrating. That's ridiculous. Sure, the sprite animations of Kid Clown getting the crap beat out of him are pretty funny, but they're not so funny after you sit there and watch them over and over and over and over. So for as much as Kid Clown and Crazy Chase gets right, it gets just as much wrong. I'd avoid this one.